When I was talking to one of the Porch Box volunteers, Les, I was asking him about referrals. How did people qualify to receive one of these porch boxes? And he said, and I thought this was quite telling, he said that they realised that the system was open to abuse. They had appropriate checks and balance, but he recognised that the system was open to abuse. Checks and balances in place to minimise that occurrence. Now, I believe that Christians are called to be countercultural. And it's a balancing act between being respected and admired for what we do, on one hand, and on the other hand, being simply dismissed as being naive, gullible fools. But how often do we hear of people saying that they're reluctant to give or help because these systems helping the poor are abused? I heard recently of a church which had a project of providing help for people living on the streets, but it was abandoned because, to quote one of the people from the church, it was being abused. On a national scale, the ex-UKIP candidate Godfrey Bloom sadly captured the sentiments of too many people when he infamously said that foreign aid went on Ray-Ban sunglasses, apartments in Paris, and Ferraris. In other words, the system was being abused. Locally and internationally, people are put off giving out of this fear of systems being abused. And I think this is an issue that Christian Aid and Church Action on Poverty have to wrestle with and have to face down. Because for many, it is a seductive justification for not actually giving. The parable of the labourers in the vineyard tells us that we worship and we are loved by a generous God. Secondly, Porch Boxes as an organisation is sensitive to the criticism that they may be, for want of a better phrase, propping up a rotten system. And one of their concerns, as I said at the start, and this could be applied to similar organisations, one of their concerns is that what should be a staging point in helping people to something better can end up being an end point. The long-term goal is sustainability and independence for those who avail themselves of the service. My final slide is a photograph from the place that Bishop David already mentioned, White Sands in Luanda. This boat, you can see that it's appropriately called Jesus of Nazareth, serving as a reminder that Jesus is always present with us, offering comfort, offering a sense of peace, making people's situations, whatever they are, more bearable. But Jesus is always with us as a challenging presence, someone who is prompting us to campaign and to lobby and pray for justice. Thank you.
I'm Veronica Sapalo, and my organization is Plataforma Women in Action, is a network for women. Our subject is to promote the participation of women in social and the public lives and gender issues. The work we are doing in Angola, in rural areas, we work in different places. We work in 80 different communities. And the problem we find there, it's about poverty and human rights. Girls and women, they live problems like culture. Because of the culture, girls, they get married since 12 years. They get married because of the culture, and the problem is that they don't know what human rights is. And the problem they are living is because of the, when you get married, you start to get children. And the women and girls, they don't have, they couldn't stop get children. They get the children all the time. And they don't know what's the problem of health, what they can do for themselves. That's why more of them died. We don't have in a community, in rural areas, we don't have a basic service like water, health service, and agriculture. They are farmers, and the survival come from the products from a field. I don't know, is it correct? Sorry, my English, I'm trying to speak.
Right, thank you.
Thank you. And because of the ausência, can you call ausência? Absent of service. Sometimes the women can do participate on the process of development because they look far away all service, like 5 and 3 kilometers to bring the service for family. And the men does know what gender issues he is. And the women say that, no, I'm women, I have got family, and this is my job at home, taking care of my family, doing all the things at home. And sometimes we find women like 20 years old, mulheres de 25 anos parece que têm 55. How can you?
Veronica was saying that women with 20, 25 years old look like they are 50 or 55 years old.
Yeah, thank you. The girls and women are looking for professional trainings, but there isn't in the community. Like, how can they cook it? How can they hire? How can they make I don't know, it's pastelaria, bakings, yeah, and so on. That's why sometimes, because of they does know, do many things, her boyfriends find another girls. This is a problem we are living in community. And when the boy left the girl, sometimes he was pregnant and take a baby. Before pregnancy, she has not support for family and the her boyfriend. And sometimes they leave the baby on rubbish. It's happened sometimes in community. The work we are doing to focus these problems is to include gender in the budget. So we are doing working the different levels. In rural areas, we are empowering the communities to know what leadership is. And we advise that they should know what human rights is because of. So we are learning the people to know what's the process of planification and how can they discuss with the government to present their problems for government resolve and get solution. So another step we are working is to strengthen the capacity of administration. How can they include poverty and people in the process of planification? So it could be to get some trainers, and sometimes we do advocacy in the high level because the recommendation and the process of the budget and planification in Angola is starting, and the process of decentralization is very concentrated. So sometimes we advise the ministers to see what's the problem administration and the community are living, and how can they change the process of making the budget, and how can they include the gender in process of budget. So sometimes we have a discussion with parliament, with the minister from MIFAM, with the women's ministers. Sometimes because of the process of decentralization, we work with Minister of Territorial to advise how can they coordinate the process of planification and budget, because sometimes the administrator can do more more workers for community, because the process of coordination, like he receive a lot of demand. Administration receive demands from local, national, like Minister of MAT, Minister de Administração and the Territory, and last one, it was about how the civils belongs in President, and sometimes from national government, national, and he could not do the work for himself, for community. So the coordination of process of this concentration and decentralization of the public service are very difficult, and sometimes we are advising and making something else for help the poor people. Thank you.